Hello everyone, welcome back. Today is the day. Today is the day we are gonna build Frostbite. Frostbite is basically the code name of my white PC build. I've been already showing some videos for the unboxing of the components and some customization I've done with basically the water cool system and the SLI cable. But today we are gonna put everything together into this fantastic case. And I'm gonna show you the process doing this basically. So basically the configuration is, as you can see more or less here, you know, it's gonna be like a Intel 5930K, six cores hyper-threading, mounted on a X99 Pro from Asus, which is, I chose this basically because of the colors, it's black and white, which is gonna fit perfectly with my build. I've bought also 16 gigabytes of memory for units of 4 gigabytes each because my processor supports 4 memory channels. So that's gonna really improve performance. It's gonna be a two-way SLI configuration. I've bought two KFA2 brand. This brand is also called Galax or Galaxy in the past. Now it's KFA2 apparently. It's a GeForce GTX 980 Ti two-way SLI. It's gonna be great. Then for the rest, storage, of course, SSD, 500 gigabyte, Samsung drive, and mechanical drive, 2 terabytes, you know, for storage. The CPU is gonna be water-cooled with a Hydro series from Corsair, H110iGT. I bought this because basically it's a closed water-cooled system. You don't have to do much to install it. That's my first approach to water-cooling. I didn't dare, you know, like, to go into full water cool systems, too complicated. I may go in the future though. The power supply, this is a marvelous power supply, 1000 watts. It's a lot, but I need that power for my, you know, only the two graphic cards is gonna be like 500 watts at peak. And also the processor is gonna take like sometimes 200, 300. So that's gonna be enough, and also gives me some room, you know, to improve in the future. And finally, last but not least, the case, Fantex N2 Lux, which is actually, I mean, I'm really happy about the case. I think it's professional case almost. I've also paid premium for that, but I think it's gonna be great. I think it's gonna be actually easy to mount there. So I think that's about it. Oh, of course, my keyboard and mouse, which is, you know, I'm not gonna use it during the build, but I will be using them later on to actually control my PC, basically. Okay, so that's about it. I think we will go for the build. I will start basically with the motherboard and the processor and the memory units. I will mount that into the case and then we'll continue from there. So I think that's about it. So let's go, let's start building. Okay guys, here we are. We will start with the motherboard, the processor and the memory first, then we will put this into the case and we'll continue. The motherboard, I've seen in several videos, you know, the ideal thing is to actually use the motherboard box to mount these things first, because, you know, it will isolate from any, you know, electrical, source that could be around, or, you know, we don't want to actually make contact and just to actually break the motherboard. So we will actually get out, and I've already taken everything else from the box, like, you know, the back plate and some other, you know, there were also some other components like an M2 adapter and everything. I took everything out. I will recommend that as well for you, so you have everything available while you mount your motherboard on top of the box. But for now, because we've done that already, we can just close the box. Okay, and put the motherboard on top. Yes, extract it from the, you know, anti-static electricity bag. Carefully and put it, yeah, on the top of the box. Yeah, that is okay. So the first thing we are gonna do is to actually install the processor. on the motherboard, and then later on we will install the memory. So for the processor, important, it has like two levers here. You have to push down, in this case, into the inner part of it.
You have to actually, one of the levers is actually locking the other lever. So you have to first pull this lever out and then this other lever out.
Okay. This is it. Okay, this is a socket. To actually install the socket, you actually have to check. There should be an arrow somewhere, a triangle indicating, you know, it has to match with the processor, same mark. So to install it, you have to first check for an arrow or a triangle. In this case, it's here in this corner. Okay, this will indicate the how to orientate the processor. You will see now. Okay, I'm gonna remove my electricity, static electricity. To do that, just touch, you know, the case or any metallic surface, so you can actually remove. If you have a static electricity strap, you can use it on your wrist or on your ankle. That's okay. I don't have it, so I won't use it. So let's get the processor out of the box. This is the processor. It's actually really beautiful. 5930K, 6 cores, hyper-threading. So 2 threads per core. Isn't it beautiful? It's really nice. So, okay, you can see here, if I put it closely there, there is an arrow on this corner. As the arrow, you have to match with the socket arrow, so it fits properly. So, okay, I'm gonna be careful here. You want to be really careful with this. You don't want to drop it unexpectedly or anything. So I'm gonna put it there with the arrow, in this case here. The arrow has to go to this side, you see? Two arrows. And then you want to drop it, yeah. Make sure you can wiggle it a little bit to make sure it's sitting properly. That is it. You put the lid back there. Now, opposite operation, you first close this guy here, right? Oh, actually, yeah, sorry, you have to, yeah. Okay, you have to, the lid has to go down, and this piece here has to be on top of the lid to push it down. Now you push it, don't worry, it's a little bit hard, but just be careful and push it down. Okay. And the plastic lid should come out. And your processor should be properly installed now. Perfect. That was easy. Okay. Now after that, we are going to install the memory units. In this case, because I have 4 memory units, because I have 4 memory channels on the processor, you won't install them in a particular way. Which in this case is for this motherboard, you have to check your motherboard. You see there are like basically a gray and black memory slots. In this case, you want to use the gray memory slots first, because basically that will allow the motherboard to use the 4 memory channels at the same time. If you put some other configuration, you may not be getting the most out of your motherboard and memory units. So the memory units, these ones actually are really cool. I already showed you in a video. I installed, you know, the upgrade kit from Corsair, which actually allows you to see the lights through. So the lights are gonna come through the window of the case. It's gonna be really great. So for the memory, what you want to do actually is, the memory has usually like a small, you know, gap there on the slot. You can see it. So you want to align the gap with the gap on the board. First, you want to actually open this side. Open, you know, this thing here,
just push it down. So you open it for the memory slot. Then you want to align the mark, the gap with the mark there. Push it down first on the left, first on the side where there is no lever. Okay, that's installed now, that's okay. Okay, and you saw the lever just came into place automatically. I didn't have to do anything there. That's one. Let's go for the second one. Okay. This is fun. This is actually really nice. It's been like ages. Oh, I just saw, guys, in my case, these memory units are coming with some plastic, some plastic there on the cursor logo. So I'll actually pull this out again. That's okay. Once installed, you can uninstall it, hopefully, otherwise you couldn't upgrade the memory. Yeah. So just push it out. Yeah. So I'm gonna actually remove this plastic, which is actually horrible. I mean, I understand it's, you know, so the cursor logo is not scratched, but yeah. And push it back. Oh, sorry, that's not the one, that is the one. One, second one, remove, same thing, and just removing there. Okay, just removing the plastic. Okay, yeah, that is perfect. I'm gonna put it here, you won't see it now, but same operation, the gray slot. Yeah, push it down. Okay, yeah. Perfect. Third memory unit now. Okay, okay. We are almost halfway. I mean, this is gonna be actually faster. Okay, this one I already removed when I was installing the upgrade kit, so there was only one left. Now the mark, the gap has to be opposite for some reason. I actually don't know why. Same thing. I'm realizing maybe, okay, let me just, maybe there is easier for you guys. I don't know, you can see better there. I'm gonna install this one first. Yeah, no, the gap is not aligned. Now the gap is aligned. Remember, important, gap align. Otherwise it won't, yeah, fit properly. This is it, and now the fourth memory unit. Same operation. Okay, actually the most difficult part of the memory unit is to get it out of the plastic. Yeah, package, okay. Same operation, remove the plastic there. Ugly plastic, plastic everywhere. Realize lately there's plastic everywhere. You can see in the news actually recently, some supermarket who was selling oranges already peeled and packaging them in plastic boxes. So some customers were complaining like, oh, come on. I mean, you're really gonna do that? Why don't you use just the peel of the orange, which comes naturally with it? Next step is going to be to put this beauty in the case. Okay guys, so we are here now with the case. I'm gonna grab the motherboard and install it here. First, you know, before you install the motherboard, you have to remember to install the backplate. You know, the backplate is basically, you know, it has all the right holes for your motherboard connectors at the back, and it's gonna go there. So you have to actually open this. Okay, let me, oh, perfect. Thought I needed scissors, but it's not the case. So you can see basically the plate. It's actually beautiful, so really nice, because it's gonna fit with my theme again. So you know, you just put it there, push it until it gets, yeah, you hear the clap, yeah,
clack, and clack. That is perfect.
Yeah,
that is actually really beautiful. Once you've done that, you have to put the motherboard here. Before doing that, if you're using the same case, it's okay. You can just do it with this specific motherboard. Thing is, you know, the standoffs are here pre-installed for you. In this case, for an ATX motherboard. My motherboard is ATX, and because this case has the standoffs already pre-screwed, then I just have to get the motherboard and put it there. If your motherboard is not ATX, or you are not using this case, you have to check for your particular scenario. Okay, I'm gonna grab the motherboard. This is it. So, you know, connectors to the back plate. Okay, that is not actually right yet. Okay. Oh, there is something not fitting. What is that about? Oh, there it is. Okay. That seems right to me. Yes. Perfect. Okay. All the holes are aligned. Right. This is really nice, guys. You see? It's gonna be beautiful once I finish. Okay, after doing that, I'm gonna grab my, you know, this is a nice, a really nice box that comes with the Fantex Ento Lux. And it's really nice. Of course, these stickers are mine. I just put them so I can easily identify which screws do I need. But it's really nice. You know, you can actually save it for later, you know, for in the future you need to do any adjustments to the case. I think this case is really great. It's a really professional case. So the ones I will be needing is the motherboard ones. I will need 9, if I'm not mistaken. I think my screwdriver, oh, it is magnetic, then it's perfect. I didn't know if it was magnetic or not, but apparently it is, so that's gonna help. So yeah, we can just... I bought these ones because basically they have LED, white LEDs, which, you know, will also be really cool. Oh, this one is not open, because, of course, I only open, you know, one of them, because they are all the same. The AF's 140, of course, so I just, yeah. Which means I should have one already open there, but I'm not gonna bother with that. I'm gonna grab this, yeah. Okay, this is it. This is gonna go here. Actually, I have to choose. Yeah, I think, you know, with the cable. Is that okay if I put the cable? Yeah, okay, I think the cable is gonna go there. It's gonna be nice. Okay, so then I will need my fan screws to basically look like this. Right? So thick, guys. Okay. Are the ones I will be using basically. Okay, that's it. I'm gonna just pass the cable to the other side a little bit. Yeah, so I can just grab it from the other side. Okay, this is beautiful. So, okay, this is it for now. Now we can go to for the water-cooled system. Okay, let's go for that. Okay, guys, yeah, basically after careful consideration, I was, you know, I wanted to put the radiator on the top and then the fans pushing through as exhaust. Yeah, I would be compromising my positive pressure, of course, but that way I could see the fans with the LEDs here. Apparently, yeah, that's difficult because I cannot put the radiator all the way to the left in this, on this case. So I cannot actually, I mean, I could do it, but then I would be doing some engineering here to actually fit it. So I'm gonna do it as it's
as it's prepared for, which is the radiator here and the fans on the top. I won't be seeing the LEDs, that's a pity. I will actually only see the LEDs of this one, because also here I bought some LEDs for the intake, some LED fans, which I won't be seeing anyway. So a waste of money maybe, but in any case, yeah. How do I do the cable management for these guys? These guys are gonna be here, basically, more or less around there. And the other guy is gonna be mounted here. So I want my cable, in this case for this guy, I want my cable going through here. Yeah, okay. And then there is a hole here at this side. I'm gonna push it there because I think it's nice to have it almost hidden. But okay, for now, this one, yeah. I'm gonna actually, yeah, put it through the hole already, because otherwise later on it's gonna be difficult with the radiator mounted here. So, there we go. There it is. We'll pull the cable through. Okay, that is nice. There it is. Okay, this is one, now the second one, which is here. Okay, this was a difficult one because I didn't expect, you know, I expected this case to have possibility to have the radiator mounted on at the top. I mean, you can put it there, but you cannot properly screw everything, so it becomes more difficult. I don't want to go there, not now. I just want this, you know, first time I'm doing this in a long time. I just wanted to, you know, to work and, you know, see that I did it properly, and then later on I may be doing some, you know, customizations to it. I will actually, I mean, I won't be completely finishing today because I'm still missing the Fantech LEDs for the interior of the case. They sell this expansion pack actually that you can buy, and then you have, it's connected to the same LEDs that this case has on the outside, and then you can actually change all of them at the same time. So I will be missing also those, so I will have to do that later on. So yeah, it won't be happening today, guys. So I will do a follow-up video with that, so you can see. Okay, this is it. Trying not to. Yeah. Okay, get the cables there. I think that's okay. So these are the two fans. I will be using these kind of screws. This came with the H110i. Okay, so yeah. So I will be using these two. Through the fans to the radiator, and now I have to put the radiator in again. It's like a sixth time I'm doing this, because I was trying to figure out exactly how to mount it, but I think now I know. So I will get one of the screws. Now this is gonna be tricky. I already see it, because you know you have to align everything. So I'm putting the screws through the fan, and then I have to align it with the radiator one. Maybe I should. Okay, let me. Now that this is like that, I'm gonna do this carefully. Yeah, come here. And I'm gonna adjust the view so you can see a little bit on the top, I think. Maybe. Like this. Okay. And like that. Yeah, it's okay, more or less, guys, I hope. Okay.
Okay. There it is, and I need two more screws. It is actually funny, I only see one more long screw that came with H110. Maybe lost it, I don't know. It's okay, I have more in the case box. Comes with both kind of screws. I kind of use, you know, one of those. It's slightly different, but I don't care. Important thing is that it holds the radiator in place. That's the important thing. I would say you have to be careful with this because, you know, this is basically sitting, you know, on the opposite side. You know, you're going through the corners of the fan, meaning the two plastic pieces are flexible, so you can always screw more. But if you do, you may be breaking it, so be just gentle as usual. Okay guys, there we go. So yeah, first thing I need is to put the standoffs for this kind. These are the standoffs for the L2011 V3. You just screw them on the corners of the socket, like that. Now, I have to put this here, the mounting bracket, and, okay, cool, yeah, and then I will put the bracket on the processor and finalize it with this on the standoffs. So now, I'm gonna remove, it has already pre-applied a thermal paste, I think it's called. So I don't need to do much there, but now I have to be careful to actually, you know, put it properly and be careful with the thermic paste. You can actually use a screwdriver, but I'm not gonna use that. I think it's, you know, the pressure you can put with your hands is more than enough. So this is set, yeah. I think it's really beautiful, guys. I mean, I'm really happy with this. So yeah, next thing is gonna be the PSU, okay guys? So let's get this guy straight up. Okay guys, let's now continue with the PSU. I'm gonna grab it. Yeah, this is actually really nice. I must say, except for the radiator, it's been a little bit of a difficult part because I thought it was going to be mounted different. I think the rest of the components are kind of easy to mount. Okay, so this is the big guy, the Cooler Master V1000. Nice. So, okay, actually really nice bag. I love the bag. I mean, I'm gonna save all the cables and everything that is left. I'm gonna put it here. Okay. So I'm gonna remove the cover of the PSU. Yeah, there are thumb screws here at the back, three thumb screws. You just have to remove them. And then the cover will come out. Okay, so yeah, this is it. Let's have to put it like this. Okay, beautiful. One thing, guys, just if it happens to you, I don't know. In my case, there are these stands here, like rubber stands for the PSU, so it absorbs all the vibrations. It should come with six. But the four I could find are basically all over the place. Like one of them was in my front fan in one of the blades. The other one was like here at the back. I don't know, I think they came off and then they traveled all across the case. But yeah, I could find four of them at least, so I can use them. But just in case it happens to you, just check it out. I mean, because if they are not here, you may think that, you know, there's nothing, and then your PSU could vibrate more than it should. So this is it there. For the screws, I have to check PSU. There it is. I was expecting them to be like symmetric, but they are not. For some reason, I'm fine with that. I just want my PSU to be properly installed. So beautiful, this is how it looks like now. So here's the deal, guys. This is the original cable that comes with the Cooler Masters PSU. I ordered a white one, but it didn't arrive yet. So again, this is gonna be temporary. It's okay. I mean, it's actually nice. It's black. It's not yellow or, you know, one of these horrible green colors. But yeah, it's not the final one. The final one should be similar to this one. But just, you know, like 24 pin connector. Okay, guys. So here's the thing, I actually need to connect this to, okay, there, 24 pin connector, can I do it? Okay, this one here, those are ones for the motherboard. Maybe I should have installed this before putting it, but okay. Yes, I want to hear the click and to make sure this is properly installed. Okay, so this is going there. This is gonna come out here at the top. I'm gonna go to the back. Okay, let me put you on the side. So I have a little bit of space here. So here's the deal, okay. Here's the deal, this is actually quite tight cable. Oh my God, this is kind of, yeah. Okay, there it is. I think that's enough. Once this is wide, it's gonna be much, much better, but okay. As my CPU cable. This is a nice one. And I just hope, because these are not really too long, so I just hope it's gonna be long enough. Okay, there it clicked. I'm gonna actually push it through this same one. Okay, into the upper part of the case. Into the motherboard. Okay. Oh my God, isn't it beautiful? Yeah. So yeah, it's actually long enough, but then I will have to see how my cable management will look like later on. That's gonna be tricky. It's okay. It's okay. These two are for the fans that come with the, you know, with the cooler. So the ones are at the top right now. So actually, I made a mistake because I pushed them. Well, not mistake, but I pushed them. Didn't actually need to, but okay. So these can actually come through here as well. So we will hide them at the back, and I will show you now, guys. Okay, I'm a little bit concerned, but maybe not. Sorry. Instead of there, I'm gonna put them here, maybe. You know, I don't actually like much, but okay, this is the way it is. Oops, excuse me, guys. This is the way it is.
Because these are radiators, this, you know, I don't actually fully like to have cables come in. Okay, maybe at the top, you know, like touching radiators, because they are gonna be really hot. And I think it's not nice, but that's the way it is right now. Not much I can do. Okay. I don't know if you can see properly, but here, I just put the cable below the thumb screw and all the way up. I think that's the best I can do right now. Okay. And I will show you at the back what I will do. I will need a SATA cable for this. One of these guys. So I'm gonna connect it here. There it is. And also to the back. Back to the future. No, back to the case. Or something. Okay, okay. Okay, guys, so this is the other side. One thing I had to do, because I was checking basically the connector for the cooler, that is this connector here. Let me show you. This is supposed to go into the CPU fan connector on the motherboard. But because I'm gonna use my my fan hat that comes with the Fantex, the problem is usually when you use the hat, then you want to connect this one here to the CPU fan. Then it will control, and it will actually read whatever you plug into this white connector here, and will use that to report to the motherboard. So I had a problem, because if I connect this to the motherboard directly, then I lose my PWM control here. So I have to change the hub from the hub is originally here, I put it here. You know, I just had to remove one of the straps, Velcro straps here, and that's about it. I think that is good enough. So it's mounted here now, and now the thing is the mess of the cables, which is always horrible. Okay, I already plugged this in into the PSU. I'm gonna just plug stuff in, and then so these two are coming from the cooler. These two are coming from the cooler. These two are the fans that are mounted on the top. These just, you know, go together. These are three pin connectors. These are four pin connectors, but there is a strap here. Like a flap, plastic flap, that will allow you to connect this only one way. There is a one pin left, which is okay. So this is here. Now, as I was saying, this one that should go into the motherboard, it's gonna be connected. Okay, so here's the deal, guys. Just had to check, and I'm a little bit confused, but okay. So basically, this little guy here from the Corsair cooler, the hydro cooler, is supposed to just report RPMs, okay, from the water pump. So the thing is, I want to connect this here, and I'm gonna connect it here, but because these flaps are bigger, because they are prepared for the motherboard, not for a hub like this. It connects more or less, but not nicely. But it's okay. As far as this report, I want the motherboard to actually see the RPMs from the hydro cooler. So yeah, that's gonna be like that. Let me just put this here. This is the motherboard CPU fan connector for the hub. This is gonna go to the other side. I will manage it now. I already connected the fans at the top to the hydro cooler, so the hydro cooler will actually control the fans directly, which is nice. I don't want to go through the hub, no need. Yeah, it just came out. And now this is it. I need to connect. This is the back
connector. I will connect it here as well to any of the fans. I guess it doesn't matter where I connect it. So, and then I will also have to okay, and I will have to also connect when I install the one on the front. I will have to connect them here, which is actually nice because it will be closer. Okay, this is it for the fan connectors and everything. Now I need to connect my SATA connectors. So I have my SATA cable here. This is for the hub itself. Yes, and this is for the cooler, which is gonna be like that. Yeah, okay. And this now is gonna be a real mess. I mean, like, I'm just seeing already cable management here is gonna be quite horrible. Let me try to see if I can do something nicer than this, because yeah, I guess something like this should work. Maybe, okay, what if I do this here? Yes, actually, cable management, I mean, it doesn't matter, it's nobody's gonna see this, like the back of the, but I expected it to be a little bit better, and I'm realizing it's gonna actually be kind of horrible, but okay, this is what it is. Okay, I'm gonna start using some of these straps for now. You know, later on we can just redo them as we see fit. Now we are gonna connect for the front case, so the rest of the, for the motherboard actually, the audio, the USB, USB 3, and the panel controls. For the panel controls, first of all, you can use this. This will ease the installation. I will show you, I'm gonna open it. So I will be using only one of them, but basically this is for the USB connector in case you have separated pins. And this is for the power and reset and everything. So this is the one I will be using. Reset to reset here. HDD to HDD LED here. And power to power. The other pins at the back are basically PLED. Power LED, I guess, which I don't know, don't know exactly. Speaker, which I don't have here, I guess. I don't guess, actually, I didn't see any, so this is gonna go at the front, and usually is here, so let me just see properly. Okay. So yeah, the connector is basically there. So I'm gonna go back. This is there. I will manage the cables at the back. Okay, and this is for the from the hub. This goes here at the top. Manage. Okay, this is just here. Okay. So first thing, one of the bays I'm gonna just remove because I won't be using this many drives. So you can actually just remove the thumb screws. Yeah, remove the bay. I hope. Was this one? Okay. There it goes, one bay. I will be using only one. The other one. I will actually use. I think that this one for the mechanical drive. Then I will install the SSD there. I think it's more out of the way, or that's what I hope, at least. Let's see. So this is the mechanical hard drive, 2 terabytes, Barracuda, Seagate one. So this basically, this comes with just some already pieces inside there that basically will click into the screw holes of the drive, and that's it. I don't know if I should maybe come from here. It shouldn't matter, actually. Yeah, it shouldn't matter. So I will just try to install it in one way. Yeah, there it is on this side. Okay. Can we do it? Oh. Okay. There it is. It shouldn't come out of there. There it is. And then it goes into the bay. Just make sure, Oh, there it is, the drive. Now for the, this one I'm gonna just remove. I won't be using this one. I'll only use this other one here. And this is for the, this is Samsung EVO 850, 500 gigabytes. It's gonna be really, really nice. So I will be installing this here. Let me find right. This okay? So I'm gonna use the motherboard screws, because they are more flat and I like them. We are gonna just put it there and installed. Is it right? So this is for the drives. Now I need power to the drives. And for power, I'm gonna grab the other SATA cable I've prepared, which is this one. I'm gonna plug it into the power supply. The only thing I need to show you again, guys, is the same as the basically the other SATA cable we've used for the fan hub and everything. So, just a connector. Interesting, or kind of interesting part is here. So, this is a problem. You see, I cannot mount this anywhere else. So I think I will be using 2 SATA cables for power because I cannot reach both the same cable, which is actually a pity. But okay, I think I'll be using this one here. So we just do something like that. Okay. And this will just come inside. And that's okay. The most beautiful one, but then I will be needing yet another SATA cable. Yeah, so I need actually a third cable. This is, it's not nice, but you know, because yeah, I need two SATA connections here, actually three, right? For the LEDs, for the hub, and for the pump. Then I need another power here, but I cannot reach the drive, so this will have to do it. Not nice, but okay. Okay, there we go. Now, this seriously, I mean, I'm pretty disappointed with these cables from the Cooler Master. Because, I mean, the PSU is great, but the cables don't have the straight input at the end, meaning I have to do things like this, you know? Just, yeah. Maybe there. Can I just do it there? Will you allow me, sir, please, to hide it there? Yeah, I think that's enough. Okay, guys, sorry for the interruption, but my camera actually ran out of battery and I had to, the other battery was still not charged, so I had to wait. In the meantime, I actually decided all these cables were actually going through this opening here. And I decided that was not good, actually. It's better to do it through these two because they are closer to the final connectors, and I'm going to show you that now. So you're going to use this guy. Oh my God, this is really heavy. I hope you can see there, yeah, more or less, right? I think it's much better because now when I put the PSU cover, you know, they're gonna just be there quite close, you know, like almost, yeah, you won't notice them. I will later on, I mean, once I finish, I will cover this with white tape so you don't see those colors there. So everything is gonna be like black and white. But okay, just for you to know, guys, I just did that. Okay, so now the thing is, I need now for the two drives, the data cables, SATA data cables, which are these ones, which are actually cool because they are black and white as well. This came basically with the motherboard, so it's great. Actually, I do have, let me check this, yeah, I have one straight, which I'm gonna use for the Samsung drive. And then a straight bent, you know, right angle for the other drive. The connectors of the motherboard are here, so I'm gonna put this here and connect this to the hard drive. Okay, this goes, this goes here. Okay. Yeah, that is nice. And this other one, this goes here, I think it's right, no, it's the other way around, of course. Okay, that's it, and this goes here. Well, now, yeah, I think I have to manage the length of this, but okay. But okay, that's about it. These are the connectors here, and these are the SATA connections. So I would say if I can do it, I would, yeah, connect that one, and then I would connect this one, yeah. So yeah, that's beautiful. Okay, so apart from the mess, because this is actually a mess,
think we are done with this. I just need the, you know, graphic cards and of course, oh, I forgot, just realized now. Also this for the pump, for the cooler, you need this to be connected to the USB head. So yeah, actually, okay. So I think this has to go, let me check. Now, this is the connection. I have to make sure, yeah, this goes like this. So I'm gonna try to, okay. Perfect, same thing, I will tape it later on. And this is the head here. I'm gonna pass it there. Yeah, why not? And here. Okay, not bad. Not bad. So this is it. Now we finished with the back because the cables for the graphic card are gonna go to the front through this opening here. So yeah, so basically we can just do the cable management now. And let's see how do we do this here. Okay, well, I think that's okay. I believe I can put the back. Oh, we are gonna install first, before we close, install the fans here. To install the fans here, it's gonna be tricky now for you guys, because, can you see this? Can you see this? I actually need to remove this filter. This is the filter that goes here, so if you have some intake fans, and now there's an opening, can you see that? Yeah, more or less, there's an opening here, yes, pull and it comes out. Now thing is, I don't know, oh yeah, I think I can actually, oh, it's actually nice, I'm gonna remove both connectors, so this comes completely, and now so we are going to install here a couple of 140. This, guys, the quiet edition again. So I basically bought two, I bought two SP, static pressure fans, and three silent edition. Quiet edition, sorry. Thing is, these also have LEDs, which won't be seen once again. Shouldn't have both, but okay. It's okay now. It's just okay. It's just okay, seriously. Okay, this, guys, remember this, the air comes this direction with the stand here with the support, so I will put them like this. Now, okay, now these two I have to connect to the hub, so I'm gonna put them, route them here.
How about that? Okay, now I'm gonna cover this with the side panel, which is here, and see if I can properly close it, because it could be, you know, like some cables are sticking out too much. So this is like this. Oh, no man, you are wrong. What am I doing? Because I'm doing it really wrong. This goes like this. It's actually nice because it actually allows you to do it like this. And okay, let's meet to here. Okay. Okay, somehow, I don't know why this doesn't screw well. I'll get another one. And get mixed. Okay. That's great, actually. It's not good because these are thumb screws. Are supposed to be, you know, screwed with the thumbs, but okay. Okay, so now the last part is gonna be the graphic cards. I'm gonna put this down and I'm gonna change the camera and then going for it. Last but not least, let's see. Okay guys, so I've done some cleanup. I've removed all the garbage and everything. Now we are going for the final step, the 980 Ti's two-way SLI. So first of all, I'm gonna connect, you know, the power cables for the cards. I'm gonna be using these cables, white ones. They're gonna come out here. So let me just connect them. Oh, this is the way actually. So this one goes there. I have to actually connect four of them because each card will use two. Okay, this is no. Have to go there, yeah. So I need four. It's actually a lot. I mean, I didn't take into account this. I overlooked a little bit. I mean, if I wanted to go three way, I may have run out of more connectors, which is interesting. But okay, I was lucky. This is gonna work. That's what I hope, at least. There we go. Okay, and last one, the PCI Express. Okay, we'll make sure they are perfectly connected, because what we are going to do now is just to put the cover. So okay, let's see. We're going to come this all through, and I'm gonna try to, because I have to put, you know, four of them through, but I also want to kind of cable manage that. I don't know if I will be able. Well, okay, let's do it this way. I'm gonna put the cover in. You know, like, yeah, and then I will manage those cables later on. Okay, yeah, I think that's about it. Okay, I will screw the cover once I finish. I may need to, you know, manage this cable here, these cables. So this is it. Now for the final step. Let's welcome our 980 Ti's. Huge cards. I mean, I won't stop repeating this. These guys are really like massive. Like, I didn't expect them to be that big. Okay, yeah. Spur cables, I'm gonna have like 200 spur cables. Okay. Oh, yeah, of course. Before we do that, I'm gonna connect basically here and here. I believe. Let me check. Yeah, 16.1, 16.2, and 16.4. Yeah. So these basically, these are going to be the ones. Because according to the user manual, you want to connect it to here and here. Basically, so you can take advantage of 16x on each port. So perfect. So I'm gonna open. Yeah, this is a tricky one because it's so huge. I need to actually see. Okay. Oh, it actually needs two. That's two. I had forgotten about it. So I'm gonna open up this. Okay. If I can. Otherwise, I will make my screwdriver. Okay, something interesting here. I hope it is okay. Because I see, you know, it's divided at the back. Oops. That should not happen, guys. Be careful. Okay. Let's see. I'm curious now because I don't know. I mean, I've seen people installing this, so I guess it's okay. But, you know, I see this thing in the middle that I cannot remove. I guess. Okay, let's see. Let us see. This is my first time installing this monster. So I found that to install the car, I actually have to hold it and push the button, you know, like push it here so I can actually properly access, yeah, the slot. Otherwise, I actually don't, not able to, yeah, to install it. But there it is. Okay. So that should be it. Oh, I'm gonna actually put back the, yeah, these ones to hold it in place. Because actually, see, yeah, okay. Yes, it's sitting a little bit on top of the X99, so hope that's okay. So, no, this one is wrong. I want it to be sitting properly. But this is huge, man. Okay, same thing here, I guess. Just need to. Okay, I just need to push the button so I can fit the card at the end. Yes. And be careful now. I want it to be. I actually don't see, which is terrible, but I hope it's sitting properly. Not there. Okay. That should be it. I'm gonna, yeah, get these guys. Same operation. Okay, now next step. Yeah, now next step is basically power cables. These are gonna be like this. No, this won't be. Yeah, like that. So I'm gonna yeah, get two and two. This is one. Oh, don't tell me I made a mistake, man. Okay. What? Guys, basically, yeah, I've seen that my cables, you know, they come with separated here, but not here. And my PSU doesn't allow me to plug a 4 and 8 pin connector. I could plug actually a 6 pin connector, but not an 8. Meaning I cannot plug this cable here. I could cut these 2 pins here out. I would have to cut the whole thing all the way down so I can fit it here. Well, I will figure that out later on. For now, I'm gonna just use the PSU cables, which are not as nice as my white cables. I'm slightly disappointed, but what can I do? Maybe I can get an adapter, you know, from 3 to 4 or something like that. For now, let's just go for, you know, be pragmatic. Let's get this running. At least I can check that works. I'm gonna grab the other cable. Okay, I won't think much about it. It's okay. So now we can do, can we do at least fanciness here? I think so, let's see. I'm gonna plug one connector there and the other one here. And then this here, if I get it, okay, perfect. This is there. No, I want it to be, yeah, that's much better. Okay, that is there. Oh no, it says yes now. Okay, and this goes here. Which I must say, I mean, it's also nice. It's not what I wanted, but it's also nice. And now, the last part I need to find, my custom-made SLI cable. Not the prettiest, but it will work. Okay. I guess that's it. Right here, how do I want to do this? Like, I want basically to put it together like this. So when I, you know, when I hide it now, it kind of stays more or less. Let's see if I can do that. I think this is it. Okay, down like a, you know, like 8 up and down. I mean, it doesn't matter, but at least it will hold it there. Okay. So this is it, guys. Not as planned, but not bad. Not bad. Okay. Okay. Oh. Okay, there you are, beautiful. Okay, guys, so this is it. Okay, I'm gonna stop here. I'm gonna just review all my cabling, everything. You know, I want to make sure this is okay. I'm gonna turn it on and then we will see. Okay, guys, so we are back and the computer is up and running. It took me a while. I had to go basically on vacation and then I had to stop. But I finally managed to set it up. As you will see now, I will show you the beast and I will explain some differences you may notice from the previous section. But this is Frostbite. I introduce you to the magnificent Frostbite. This is the machine running. We'll open it now, and you will see properly without the reflections. Don't worry. This is it. It's working. It's working. Yeah. So, well, apart from the fact that you can see white cables there, some more white cables there. You already saw. So yeah, finally I realized that the cables I bought from Corsair were not the ones I needed for my Cooler Master power supply. Meaning it was a pity that I couldn't use those, so I had to buy new ones specifically for the Cooler Master PSU. But yeah, well, apart from that extra expense, the thing is working like a charm.
Well guys, so as you can see, some time has passed. My hair is shorter and my beard is shorter, but I promise it's been only a week I've been away. Before I went away, I managed to actually have the computer up and running. I also managed to install Windows and Ubuntu with a dual boot. But the most important thing I learned when I was trying to set up to get it up and running, I couldn't get the image on the screen, which was, like, you know, surprising. This particular graphic card, the Galax or KFA2 Hall of Fame 980 Ti, they have two display ports, actually three display port connections each, which was like, what? I mean, I can imagine two of them is maybe for dual monitor setups, but the third one, I haven't even checked. The thing is, I tried and I couldn't make it work, and you know, I tried six, you know, connections. I was like, what the? Come on, I mean, one of them should work. Then I realized that my monitor, the Asus ROG Swift PG279Q, basically doesn't detect automatically the input. So if you want the monitor to, you know, to show the input of the graphic card through DisplayPort, you actually have to go to the menu and select DisplayPort. Once I did that, I just had to connect, you know, to the graphic card with this on top, to the connection that is closer to the window. It worked. Then I could see, I could go to the BIOS, and from that, you know, I configured the whole thing. I will explain in a separate video what configuration did I do. I applied some XMP settings. I haven't overclocked yet. But apart from that, apart from the overclocking of the memory, I've applied some optimized settings in the BIOS. But haven't really went to overclocking it. And that's basically about it. I'm really happy with it. It was kind of easy to stop. Was running properly. One problem I had basically was the other day I turned it on and the BIOS complained about the CPU fan not working properly. So it basically didn't allow the computer to boot because, you know, it's €10 if your CPU fan. I checked and I realized that when I was changing my cables from black to white, I had moved, you know, slightly some connectors and they, you know, they were not connecting properly. So I had to, you know, push them slightly farther, you know, make sure all connections were correct, and it worked. So, only change I've done, guys, from the setup you just saw. The white cables, I just had to buy new cables for my Cooler Master V1000 because the ones I had were for Corsair. So I guess maybe if I had a Corsair PSU, they would have worked. But now I have like a lot of spare cables, which is okay. I don't know, I will use them maybe eventually. But for now, I'm really happy with the white cables. And the second thing I had to do was the way I connected all my fans to the fan hub. I was not happy with it. So what I did in the video is I connected all my fans in the case to the fan hub, and the fan hub has one special connector, white connector, which will be used. Basically, the fan you connect there is the one reporting to the cable coming from the fan hub. That cable I connected to the CPU connector, CPU fan connector on the motherboard. The idea for me was like, okay, so, you know, it's important to keep the CPU cool. So if a CPU temperature goes up, then the whole case will, you know, be synchronized and, you know, increase the speed of the fans. Funny thing is the CPU is right now as we speak at a constant 39 degrees and the CPU package at 49 degrees, which is, you know, way below anything I would expect. So even while playing games or, you know, benchmarks, CPU benchmarks increase the temperature, raise the temperature a little bit, but not enough. So the thing is, you know, it's like the whole case was quiet all the time, which is good. But the GPUs were reaching like crazy 92 degrees. And then I thought, okay, so I need actually to link my GPU temperature to the fans in the case. So when the GPU is, you know, hot, at least the airflow in the case is higher. So what did I do? I disconnected the pump, the water cool system from the hub, and I connected it directly to the motherboard on the CPU fan. So it's kind of useless just to report RPM, but that's fine. And then what I did is I connected all the fans in the case to the fan hub, and the cable coming from the fan hub, which will allow to measure the RPMs of the fan connected to the first connector in the fan hub. I connected that cable to the, I think it's chassis 3 fan connector on the motherboard. That way I can separate the control of that CPU pump fan or report, because it doesn't allow to control, and the chassis, the case fans. So then I will explain in another video how did I do it. I had to use some software, but now when the GPU temperature raises, then the case itself, all the fans in the case, the ones in the front and one at the back, they, you know, increase speed to allow for more airflow. The ones at the top are just intake and basically are controlled by the water-cooled system from Corsair. Cannot do much there. I downloaded the application from Corsair to control it, you know, a little bit more of a tuning there, but that's it. So I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna just open the window, and I'm gonna show you the internals of the PC. Yeah? And this is the naked without window PC. You can see how beautiful. Well, I guess I will show you in another video, yes, during night, you know, no lights, no sun, so you can actually enjoy. Okay, I think it's out of focus. I cannot do much about it with this camera, so at least you can see. No, quite a clean setup. The thing is, nice, you can see there the other fans. And the thing I love, well, maybe not most, but really cool because I didn't plan for it, is finally these two fans with LEDs. You know, I thought if I put them there, I wanted to put them below the radiator, but it couldn't be possible, so I had to put them on top. And I thought, it's a pity, because then you won't see, but you can see through this mesh here. I'm gonna actually open it. And there you can see how beautiful it is. Nice, huh? Okay, let me put it back. So, what do you think, guys? I personally love it. And I've done a lot of configuration and personalization of some settings.
some benchmarks. I will explain about that in a follow-up video, but for now I think it's okay. I think this has been a long enough video for now. I hope you've enjoyed it. I've really enjoyed building this PC. First time in 10 years I do it, and I'm really happy about it. I think the performance is amazing. So I will explain in a follow-up video some problems I found with this particular setup, with a two-way SLI, how I configured, you know, all the cooling part, all the software I had to download for that, some benchmarks, some configuration for fine-tuning, everything in follow-up videos. For now, I think it's enough. I want to thank you for watching it. If you liked it, please click like below, because I would really, you know, like to know that people is watching my video. If you really liked it, please subscribe. If you don't like something as well, tell me in the comments below. Tell me also in the comments if you have similar setups, or, you know, you found problems or something you think I can improve with this setup. So thank you very much, and see you next time.